This here, this is Herman. Herman is a butcher from a small village in the Netherlands. He's not just a butcher. He's also a firefighter and a hunter. He hunts to keep the animal population healthy in the forest. But he also hunts because he wants to provide seasonal meat for his clients. Herman is one of those ambitious butchers. He's forward-thinking, he's young, and he wants to exist still in the future. Besides that, Herman is actually also a specialist in sausage making and hams and all terms of preserved foods. And that was exactly what I needed. I needed Herman, the sausage expert, and the open-minded one. Because I have a mission. And my mission is to reduce the amount of meat we eat by using the existing industry. And yes, the sausage. Did you know that the sausage is one of the oldest designed food items? It originated out of a fish and butchery, because back then you can imagine that there was no waste possible. You cannot waste any food. It was also one of the reasons why we could travel, because it was one of the first compact sources of proteins and energy that we could take with us. And we could actually start to explore the world. We could go north to colder climates. And it's exactly that part of the sausage that I think is so fascinating. It has 5,000 years of development. 5,000. That's long. And still now, the sausage is very popular. I mean, England alone has 470 different types of breakfast sausages. Besides that, the sausage is also a master in disguise, which comes in very handy when it comes to a new protein source that is coming our way. Although 80% of the world already eats them. And maybe you feel it coming or not, but I'm talking about insects. If you have never, ever thought of insects as a food source, I understand you're probably thinking, ah, this is really disgusting. But don't worry. Research has shown if you eat something for 8 times in a different safe environment, you will learn to love it. And it does not only count for insects, it counts for other ingredients. So try it. I was intrigued. I was intrigued in working with insects, so I called up my butcher, my expert, Herman, and said, Herman, do you want to make insect sausages with me? He didn't even hesitate, actually. He just said, yeah, let's go for it. So I came there with my box of fresh worms to his butchery on a Saturday morning, and we started his expertise on sausage making, my newly found knowledge on how to use insects as food, and we started together making sausages. We used his machines, we used his techniques, we used even the skins that he has in the butchery. Everything was going really well. We were making a bratwurst, which worked good. You can see it on the picture here, it's coming out of the machine. And we also made a salami, a nice dried sausage. But then, at one moment, we were looking back to what we did in the morning, and we realized they had turned black. I knew about this, but I didn't really know what we did wrong. I thought we followed all the steps. This is when I realized that me and Herman, we have just met the limits of our knowledge. We're both trying to be experts, we are experts, but we didn't know how to solve this. And that's when it hit me. This is the problem with change. If you want to change, it means you often have to go into the unknown. And who likes to go into the unknown? We like to stay in our circle of expertise, because that's when we know best. But I do really think that this is something that we can help and work on. That's when I decided I would make a manual. I would dive into ingredients, I will make a manual, and I will write little descriptions of different ingredients, because then with that, this step into the unknown can be so much more easy. So I looked into different types of ingredients and processes, and that's when I started to look also in the world of plants. Oh, there's so many amazing plants. I looked into seeds. I looked into grains. You have hundreds of legumes and nuts that are fantastically nutritious. I selected about 100 ingredients. They all have one thing in common, that they all fit perfectly well in a sausage. But they are also selected for different reasons. Like, can they replace meat protein? Yeah, some of them can. Or what nutritional other values do they have? In terms of flavor, they should also taste nice. But I also looked outside of that and I was thinking, go a bit further and select them also for being a strong crop, being widely available, not using too much water. One thing I found out when I was looking into this big world of ingredients is that quite many of them are not found in our supermarket. I find it strange that when we say we have to be efficient with our food, we actually do not eat what's around us, we eat what's in our supermarket, which is quite a poor selection, especially in terms of plants and flowers. That made me think, like, why are we this, my Latin description, eximius folivores? Why are we supermarket eaters? We used to be omnivores. Let's be an omnivore again. So there you have it, a set of ingredients, an amazing food item with 5,000 years of development, an established industry. So I propose, let's reduce the amount of meat we eat. And reduce, I'm not saying, let's stop eating meat. You know, the sausage is a very efficient food item, but I think we can use it for so much more than that. So let's reduce the amount of meat we eat by using the existing infrastructure with all its experts, by using the existing machines and all the techniques. Why would we invent new machines and techniques? But we merely invite new ingredients in this process. And therefore, I want to present to you to the sausage of the future. Because did you realize that a salami could actually be made out of fruit? This one is forest fruits, nuts, and flowers. And it's made with the same machines at the butcher with Herman. The same machines, the same drying chamber, and it even does not compromise in the functionality because it can go 2 years without refrigeration, just like our beloved sausage salami could. Or the breakfast sausage. Yes, we can put herbs and spices next to the meat, but we could also try every once in a while to put something completely different in there. Like these ones, they're filled with peas and potato. And the orange one is quite exotic, I thought, is carrots and ginger and coconut. I also try to rethink a little bit, like when and why do we eat the sausage? Did you think about having a sausage for a dessert? Because I found this ancient recipe in Italy and I thought it was fantastic. It's blood and chocolate. And all the children love it. So I thought, okay, let's try this. Let's reinvent an old blood sausage that's actually kind of being frowned upon a bit now by our younger eaters. So this one contains blood, chocolate, I added almond. And the yellow center that you see is the center of apple. And like that, you can fry it in a pan. And it tastes very subtle, slightly sweet, and it's really delicious. And then we made a pâté, a nice, smooth pâté. But this one, yeah, this one is made out of insects. It's dipped in beeswax for its preservation. And I have to say, I would challenge you to try it. Bon appétit.